is living. This is style. This is elegance by the mile. Oh, the posh, posh.
Have you seen my red wool?
No, I haven't. And I hope you're not insinuating anything by that. Out.
Can I have a word with you?
I said get out of here, Miss Parslow.
Pull up a bed, love, and let's hear it.
Stupid, ignorant, silly little old
woman. Oh, what's the problem?
Oh, what isn't? She's one big one herself.
I was wondering whether it wouldn't be a good idea if I left here and went to live on the outside.
What's brought this on? Senility. It's got to be.
I'll have you know I've given it very serious thought. You see, the problem is I've got all this lovely money in the bank. And I could do such wonderful things with it.
Oh, Ettie, you're a prize, love, you really
are. I don't think good works are very funny.
I'm sorry, love, it's a terrific idea, but you've got to
be... See, the question is, do I open a home for war veterans, or do I do something for the kids? I mean, after all, they've got their whole lives ahead of them.
Ettie, love, I don't want to be a wet blanket, but I think you've got a few problems ahead of you before you get to the good deeds.
What problems? I might have enough for both.
Ettie... You held up a bank to get back in here. And the way you carried on at your committal, well, you'll have a hell of a job to convince them to let you out again.
Oh, no, dear. Meg will take care of all that for me.
Right, you two, round the bank. You two stay here. Frank and I are going inside.
Megsy, don't say I ain't fair. Got to play fair, haven't we, Cruckshank? Now get over there.
Don't be a fool. You'll be up for life.
Worth it, boy. Oh, bloody worth it. Now move!
We all need a good cry sometimes, Daphne.
Yeah. What I really need is a really good lawyer. Perry Mason.
Who?
I don't think he's available, Ettie.
What? I think Perry Mason's all booked out.
Oh.
Now, don't worry, we'll fix you up with something.
See, it's even more important now that I get out. My poor son-in-law needs all the help he can get.
What? Oh, you mean Mr. C?
No, he's going to be all right. Mrs. Barry told us he came through the op okay.
Poor Meg, such terrible things.
Oh, Ettie, come on, cheer up.
They got you, haven't they?
Yeah. I'm going to be an auntie grandma.
It's Mrs. M. Preggers.
Certainly not. They're not even married yet.
Oh, yes, but she will be.
Oh, it's a lucky baby. You'll make a great granny, Ettie.
You sure will, love. In fact, if you've got time, my little one wouldn't mind an auntie grandma too.
Okay, ladies. Queenie Marshall. Hi, chickens. Come on, Flynn. Governor's office.
Hope it's good news, love.
Thanks.
Yeah, fingers crossed, Nor.
Thanks, girl.
G'day. Not too bad here, but the looks of it.
Depends how long you stay.
Oh, you make it sound like a hotel, aren't you, mate?
Yeah, well, why not, ducky? 7 days of taking it easy and no bill at the end. It's all right in my books.
7 days? Geez, you're lucky.
Yeah, beat up this John because he decided he wasn't paying.
You must be strong.
No, he was already tied up. See, I take care of the kinky ones. Rotten bastard, I beat him black and blue like he always wants, and he lays a charge. You just can't please him. Hey,
takes all kinds, eh?
Hey, you must meet some real weirdos.
Oh, yeah, they have their moments.
Where are you, you little bugger? Gotcha! Oh, no, I haven't. Oh, Struth.
What a
am I going to do?
You all right, love?
Eh? No, I'm not.
What's up?
There's a frog on my bucket.
A frog?
Yeah, I saw him. He popped his head up and looked at me.
Having me on?
I'm not. He looked at me.
But it's full of cleaning fluid stuff, isn't it?
But I'm frightened about it. It could be poisoned. Oh, where could he be?
Oh, well. Happy fishing.
I listen. What was all that carry on before in the rec room, you know?
Oh, cuddle bum, you mean?
Yeah, that big man with a moustache.
Yeah, well, he was just one of my friends, that's all.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, he comes to see me and my girls every now and again.
I didn't know you had a family.
Pardon?
You know, I would like to have had girls myself if I'd got married.
Oh, no, they're not my daughters, sweetheart. They're girls, you know, working girls.
Oh, well, you tell them from me, they're very lucky to have a nice job. With the war still going on, they could be putting munitions, you know.
Yes, dear, whatever you say. Oh, but don't worry about it. I take very good care of them. Oh, we've got this nice little house and we all live there together. And they've got their own bedrooms and they have plenty of pocket money.
Oh, isn't that nice? Yeah. You know, there are a couple of girls in here going to need some help when they get out.
Oh, well, don't look at me, love. I mean, I haven't got any vacancies at the moment. Mm. But if you were on the outside, you could set up a place of your own. You know, with your own girls and help them out. And we'll make sure they don't get into any trouble.
Maybe I could.
Well, I've got to go to the toot. I'll see you later.
Yeah.
Found that frog yet? He might have turned into a prince by now.
He might have drowned by now. How did he get in there in the first place? I want to know.
Minip!
And that should be all that's needed.
Ettie, please slow down. I'm not sure I understand you.
But it's dead simple. I made a mistake, that's all. I don't mind admitting it. I'll sign all the forms, all the paraphernalia, as long as I get out of here tomorrow morning. I've got lots to do tomorrow. I've got to get cracking.
Are you saying you want to leave, Wentworth?
I've got to. Oh, don't worry. I'll stay with Sadie until I pull my socks up and get myself organised.
It is not that simple.
I can't stay with Meg, not with Dennis the way he is, can I? I mean, he's a nice boy. I'll go and visit him. He's been very good
Ettie,
to me,
it's not that easy. I'm not allowed to let you go.
But why not? You're the governor, aren't you?
You have to go to trial and convince the jury you're innocent.
But what for? If one knows I didn't mean it.
We'll call your solicitor. But you may have to change your plans.
Oh, it's ridiculous. Bloody ridiculous.
Oh, do you know where the governor is?
She asked to speak to the council. They're meeting in the rec room.
Oh, I see. You've got to ask to speak to prisoners these days, eh? God, this place needs tightening up. Anyway, I haven't got time to chase her. Here, give her this.
I'm just leaving. I'm going to see Dennis.
Yes, I noticed you've been changing the rosters to suit yourself lately.
That is not true. I'll see Anne gets it.
Yeah, well, it's for Egbert. So it's going to have to wait till the United Nations comes out of session.
So I'm very glad to be able to tell you the department's agreed on a trial basis to classes being held during work periods.
Oh, well, that's very good.
Mm. They'll be held during the first half hour of the morning work session and the last half hour of the afternoon session. And the same classes will be held both times, so if you want to tackle more than one subject, you can. Perhaps dressmaking in the morning or general knowledge in the afternoon, something like that.
Oh, beautiful. Well, at least they're talking sense for once.
Of course, they have made one stipulation.
Oh, yes,
what is it?
That they're not to be abused. If you're not attempting the classes, then you'll have to work as normal. And anyone who doesn't take them seriously will be sent straight back to work.
Well, that seems fair enough to me. Well, it's not you we're interested in, dear. This is a council decision. Now, are we all in favour of this?
Yes.
All right, well, carried, or whatever they say.
I also have to tell you Mr. Fry's resigned.
Oh, really? Why?
Apparently his health's been failing for some time.
Yeah, so Queenie said.
So whoever takes over from him will have to handle the business of everyone signing waivers in regard to the siege. Now, let me stress, I don't want to sway you either way. I can only imagine what you went through. But I honestly don't think you'll gain anything by going ahead with compensation claims.
Yeah, it's your job, isn't it, to take their side?
No, I think Mrs. Reynolds is right. I mean, if we were to go ahead and sue the department for compo, we'd have to prove that those men got in here because the department was negligent in protecting us properly.
Well, we can do that, no worries. Ferguson was on duty that night. She probably opened the door for him.
I'll try and talk sense, Jenkins.
Well, even if it wasn't their fault, I'm still a bundle of nerves.
Yes.
I get like that myself sometimes.
Yeah, problem is that nervous shock or any kind of mental disturbance is almost impossible to prove in court. It could take years.
I haven't got years.
Not impossible, surely.
Well, there was a precedent set in 1968, but I don't think that...
How come you know so much all of a sudden?
Because my jockey's a smart piece of work, that's why.
No, I seen it on the telly.
I think you'll find Julie's right.
Yes, and even if we did win, they'd take away our privileges.
Just to be spiteful.
If that happened, I'd have something to say.
Well, all right. All those in favour of recommending to the women that they sign these waivers, raise your right hands.
Big mistake, you lot.
Carried.